is Chief of IFI, actually I'm from the Refugee Care Center in Egypt. Today I'm going to talk about the commonly used solvent and its effect on the animal brain. The question is, why are we need to use solvent on We have two types of problems we will see. A photograph itself probably will go to preventive conservation action. Actually, never. We recommend always doing a preventive conservation action, doing a minimal invention to the photographs, which will be much more better. But some problem is coming when we are facing a photograph in Cunan. Photograph in Cunan is actually the first printed books which has a real photographs to start from the mid-19th century. The problem which we are facing on the photograph in Cunan, it is that a printed book which has a photographs. And probably we need to do a deacidification and we will need to use solvents. Probably we're going to do a disinfection or any other treatment regarding the acidity and all the treatment of that book. Here is the problem. When you are studying an object before conservation, you should know clearly the object history. But doing a wrong conservation of the object will lead to a wrong conservation, as we can see in the chart here, will lead to a significant acceleration decay, accelerated decay to the object. That's why we need to study all the material and its effect on the object. The methodology of the research is that we have already made a study on six from the 1860s albumen brands in the size of cardiovascular, which is a small size, it's known as an albumen brand. From the selected photographs in this study has been examined to test the effect of most commonly used solvent and conservation laboratories. I've already prepared the photo, the six photographs, already specific areas to make the laboratory test, mainly on the left corner and on the face of the object on the photograph. I've already tested nine of the most commonly used solvent on conservation laboratory, which was mostly all of us are using. For instance, ethanol, methanol, acetate, ethyl alcohol, and benzene, ammonia, hydrogen peroxide, and hexane, and isopropyl alcohol as well. The test has been done on the object before and after treatment using a microscope, a stereoscope microscope, and pH measurement, nitrate spot test, and ETR-FTIR analysis. We're going through the result. During the visual inspection or the magnification after and before treatment, the solvent test doesn't show any visible changes to the surface layer after complete drying. Some minor dust appeared on the cotton swab as the only cleaning process. So the solvent didn't do any effect, visual effect to the surface of the photographs and the silver mirroring phenomena as well. Didn't remove it. Doing the nitrate test, a deep violet is obtained as a result of a
positive test indicate when nitrogen reacts with amino acid. When we indicate on the swab after doing the test using the swab, using the solvent on the swab and doing the test using the same swab, we are obtaining a drop of nitrogen as a test. When it obtains a deep violet, it means that I've already removed from the surface of the amide or the surface of the photograph itself. It means it's a removal from the albumen of the photographs itself. Actually, all the result, all the solvent obtain a positive and result for removing the albumen from the surface. It means that all the solvent have already removed a layer from the albumen bread. Even it is not visible. Doing a pH measurement for the photograph which has been tested before and after applying the solvent, result obtained from the test solvent in case of ethanol and acetone, ethyl alcohol, ethyl acetate, isopropyl alcohol, and hexane and ammonia result in a slight increase of the surface pH in a range of 0.5 units. Hydrogen peroxide and isopropyl alcohol showed a higher increase of pH value in an average of 1.1. Finally, benzene and methanol showed a slight pH decrease in a range of 0.5 unit. So most of the solvent have already make an increase for the pH. After doing an ETR, FTIR measurement result, it's a non-destructive analysis technique has been done on the missile. It has been done months after applying solvent to the tested area, and each result was compared with an ETR, FTIR of untreated area, controlled site as well. On the same photograph test. The result come from methanol, which is detrimental to health. I would like to mention that. It was stable. That's the only result which was stable using a methanol. But actually, methanol is used regularly for human. For ethanol, acetone, ethyl acetate, isopropyl alcohol, benzene, hexane, distilled water, it has shown that some hydrolysis on the samples itself. It increases in the amide 1, the peaks already shows increase in amide 1 and amide 2, and increase in OH band as well. It means that the emulsion, the photograph emulsion has been destroyed or has been deteriorated. If we are going to the conclusion, also, this commonly used solvent did not show any visible site of damage either to the naked eye or using a microscope. The nitrogen test and ETR-FTIR analysis showed that the effect of this solvent on the albumen layer were detrimental in all cases. It is not recommended to use solvent on photographs, especially albumen prints, with these nine tested solvent. Thank you.
Thank you.